Hi friends, welcome to Tekken Tourism channel. I'm so happy to give you another technical information on Python. There's going to be in several phases. Today I'm going to teach you only about the Python basics for you, how to get started with Python variables, Python data types, and Python constants and Python strings. Okay, welcome to our channel. Please subscribe and press the bell button below. So let's go to the Python programming. Before going to Python programming, today concept is going on Python basics. I'm going to use Jupyter software. If you are not using Jupyter software, you can download it. It's very easy. And I have also put the video on how to download Jupyter. You can use that and download Jupyter. There are several Python programming platforms there. We have Python, IPython, and Anaconda, and we have several other Python softwares. So I'm using Jupyter. This comes under Anaconda. So this is the Python basics part one. Today we are going to see about introduction to Python, Python interpreter mode, values and data types, variables, constants, expressions. Okay, these are six things we are going to see in our today's session. So introducing to Python. Python is a general purpose, high level and object oriented programming language. And this uses interpreter. You previously used the compiler and all those things, but Python uses interpreter for translation and execution of one statement at a time. And actually is developed by Guido van Rossum in 1985 to 1990. You may ask, when it is invented long back, why this now Python is very famous? Because now they want they don't want too much of software involved, too much of coding involved. They want simple coding, because for machine learning and deep learning, they want the software, but at the same time, it should be very simple, because their aim is not to develop a big things. They want to implement machine learning and deep learning. So we are using Python nowadays. So Python converts the source code into intermediate form called bytecodes. Python converts the source code into intermediate form called bytecodes. Then it is converting to the computer language. So Python is now very famous. Is going to be the future for machine learning, deep learning, artificial intelligence. Everybody, because everybody started using programming, and they saw one inbuilt libraries and so many things. That's why Python is very famous now, though it's invented long back. No compilation, but interpretation is done here. The main advantage of Python is huge standard libraries are available in Python. So another thing we can say, there are two types of modes are there. We have an interactive mode and script mode. You can see here, this is interactive mode, and we have script mode. Interactive mode means each command when you type, it will tell whether it's correct or not. Not after typing 10 commands or 11 commands. Each command when you type, it will say whether it is correct or not. The feedback is given immediately. For example, if you type 2 plus 1, the interpreter immediately will say 3. Okay, so then you can check now and then each line of command you can check. That is called interactive mode. Script mode is as we write in other programs. You know, we write all the integers, float and all those things. Then write the input command formulas. Then finally put print and run. Right, so total program is written and you run. It's called script mode. But each and every line, that's advantage now, interactive mode. Each and every line you type and you can see whether it is correct or not. Any error is there. That is interactive mode. So all script mode should be saved as .py, Python. No? So .py you have to save, like you save .c for C program. Here you have to save as .py. So these are the modes of operation, interactive mode and script mode. So let's go to the basic program, where I'll start Jupyter and start doing. Now first we are going to type how are you without space, and then we are going to see how we can use a small integer. So let's go to the Jupyter. So I'm going to search for Jupyter. It's already installed in my this thing, Anaconda. So once it is there, it will open. Usually Jupyter opens in web page like this. Already have many files. I'm going to click here, new. So once you open Jupyter, the Jupyter will open in the web page only. So this you can see here new. This is a text file, means you write all the scripts, all the codes you write, and then execute, save as .py and execute in the terminal. So now I'm going to use interactive mode. So I'm going to use Python 3. So this is interactive mode, that like this will come in bracket, all those things. So here you can type the code and see whether it's working. So first you're going to print simple statement. This is a script, so I'm using single quote should be used. How are you? Okay, so after typing, you can put run. It will give you the answer, how are you. So in C program, we use printf. Now we are using only print. There is no printf, only print. So for example, here you want to give some values like 2 plus 3. The answer will come. So this is interactive mode. When you type, the answer will come. You type, the answer will come. So you can keep on writing, or you can keep on writing here also, like x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, and then you write d is equal to x plus y, then I put print d, it will execute here itself, answer will come. So interactive mode, this is whether you can write all the programs, or you can step by step, you can see how it's working, then you can make it as a big program. So this is very comfortable for us to use. So this is about the starting, no? Just print and type your script, there's characters, it will print. So we have to put in codes. Always, as you know, the script also we should be written in the codes. So next thing is, this is a basic programming. So like we write already, I did 10 plus 5 and put click here, run. It will give you 15. So next we'll go to the, after basic program, the next one is going to this string, Python string. String is, you know, what is the meaning of string? We write some English alphabets, right? In the quotes, it will be some the string. So actually this should be in single quote. So here you say, how are you? I'm writing, assigning this how are you to str. So like we assign the variables, right? X equal to 3, x equal to 4. Like we assign the variable. Str is the variable. I'm assigning the value how are you without any space. And the answer will come when you put print str, you give how are you. Then what all we can do with the string? I want the first letter from the string, means what I should do. I want from letters 2 to 7, means what to do. I want from 2 to all the things what to do. Like that we are going to see now. So always remember, in string in Python, the first character will be taken as 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. Whereas in the reverse side, it will take from minus 1. Right? Minus 1, 0, 1, 2, like that. So when you go from this side to this side, you always remember it starts from 0. So that's how we are calculating. H is 0, O is 1, W is 2. So with that, we are going to see how to use multiply the strings and add concatenate strings. So when you want to multiply the strings, you have to put star. When you want to add something to a string, you have to put plus. Okay, so see here you see print string of 0 means the first letter, right? 0, H is the answer. When you put print string 2, colon 7 means from 2 till 6 only it will take. First it will take 2. After that colon, what you put 7 means only up to 6 it will be there. Okay, it will be only up to 6th character will be there. 2 to 7 means 0, 1, 2. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from W to Y it will print. Starting from 2 till 6th value, not 7. If you put 7, previous one will be taken for the ending. That is what is print string 2 to 7. If you see the next one, print string 2 colon. That means from second character, you give me all the things. That means 0, 1, 2. 2 is W. From W, all the things will be printed. W, A, R, E, U will be there in the output. So star 2 means 2 times it will print. How are you? How are you? It will come. Star 2. String star 2 means string 2 times. How are you? How are you? Will be coming. We'll be seeing that in the programming. String plus we are putting boy in the quotes means how are you? Boy, it will come. Whatever is there in the string plus what is the character you are giving will be printed. Let's see this in Jupyter. So I am putting str, that is string is equal to, I am taking another value, how are you? Okay, so I am running it, it is coming. So I am printing what is there in the string, print string, the same thing, this variable I am printing what is there. So answer is how are you? So this how are you is stored in the string. So when I type print string, how are you is coming. Now we'll just play with the string commands. So first is get the first character. So I want string of, I want letter from 2. Okay, string of 2. What is there? W. 0, 1, 2. 2 is W. 0 is H. 1 is 0. 2 is W. So when string of 2, W is coming. Next, I want from one particular character to another character. So, for example, I want from 2 to 7, right? We discussed before. 2 to 7. So, what is the answer? See, 2 to 7 means W-A-R-E-Y. 2 is what? 0, 1, 2. 2 is W. After that, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is Y. So, till Y it is coming. W-A-R-E-Y is coming. It is not taking the 7th one, 0. Because I said, starting 2, it will consider. If you put 7, till 6 only it will take. If you put 8, it will take up to 7. If you put 9, it will take up to 8. So, 1 before the final will be taken. Already we discussed. Then I want all the characters from one particular one. For example, string of 3 colon. And I am putting run. Ru. 3 is what? 0, 1, 2, 3. 3 is A. From A, all the letters will be here. Ru. Okay, so that is about the this one. Then next we can see string of concatenation, right? Then now I have to assign something because we are going to use the string. So I am putting ss is equal to string star 2. Then I am saying print ss. See, how are you? How are you? 2 times it is printed. How are you? How are you? Okay. So, 2 times. Concatenation, this is 2 times. This is actually repetition. Sorry. Repetition is star. When you use star character for repetition, so star 2 means how are you? How are you? Concatenation means adding. So, same I am putting SSS is equal to string plus boy. So, I am adding something to existing string. So let us see what is the answer. So I have to put print, right? Then only answer will come. Print, because we are assigning SSS. See, how are you, boy? So string is how are you. We already declared string is equal to how are you. So that string plus boy in the quotes, because boy is a character, so we have to put in the quotes. So how are you, boy, is printed. So this is about the string. So we can do repetition, we can do repetition, we can add it, we can take from particular point, from starting to ending we can take the alphabets. So this all we can do in the strings. Much more in the strings we will be seeing in next session. Now we'll go for the only the basics. There are many other things we can do with string. Next, go into the Python variables. Now, variables, already you know, assigning something. Here, what is the advantage in Python? We need not declare an integer or float or character like C program. We have to declare. In Python, it will automatically understand whether it's an integer or float. No need to define it. For example, here we are putting x equal to 8, t equal to 5.0, that is floating. Whenever decimal comes, that's the floating. Without decimal, it's an integer. V is equal to Python, that is we are putting in quotes, that becomes a string. When you put in quotes, that becomes a string. And C equal to 10, D equal to 11, we are assigning 10 to C, we are assigning 11 to D. As a C and D are variables. Variables are something where we can store the values. So in C and D are variables. So we are printing C and D. Output will be 10 and 11. So let's see in the Jupyter. So I said no need integer, right? So you see here x equal to 8, y equal to 11, c equal to x plus y. I'm not declaring integer or float anything. Then print c. See, 19. 11 plus 8 is 19. Did I declare integer? No. Without the answers. That's the advantage of Python. One advantage, that is no need to declare the data types. And the next is we are going to see, that's about the Python variable. And next we are going to see about the constants. See here, pi equal to constants, you know, it's a fixed value. Pi equal to 3.14, g equal to 9.8. And like that, I've taken the example a equal to 20.1, b equal to 10.1, c equal to 15. You can put e equal to a plus b by c and print e. Constants, you know already, this is similar to variable. Pi becomes a variable, g becomes a variable. Only thing is decimal value, that's fixed values will be used. So how to use the constants? Just I'm putting pi is equal to 3.14. g, acceleration due to gravity, is 9.8. So fixed value, just I'm adding c is equal to pi plus g, print c, and just run it, 12.94. So constants also can be used. So no need to declare constant like C program, right? We put define constant pi equal to all those things. No need to. Directly it will consider as a constant. So this advantage of Python, my dear friends, today we saw about the what is the basics of Python, what is the advantage of why Python is famous now, because it's very easy for using for artificial intelligence. That's why it's becoming the future. Next 10 years is going to be artificial intelligence, so better to learn Python. It's very easy because you have a lot of inbuilt libraries. And we saw about what is a string and what are we going to do with the strings. Then we saw what about the variables and how to assign the value to the variable. Then we saw what is a constant. Good luck, friends. Try to practice Jupyter and wait for the other videos. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Have a great day.